going on, guys? Jake Gottesman here, Director of Nutrition for Overtime Athletes. Today, I want to talk to you guys about something that's very important for a lot of you, and that is game day nutrition. A lot of you, you know, you're athletes, this is going to be a make or break day for you guys a couple times. Throughout the season, you might only have a couple times to perform. This may be the day that scouts are looking at you, so you want to make sure you're at your absolute best, as this could be a huge make or break moment for some of you. So a couple of my game day tips, or these are kind of my gems that I tell all my athletes that they need to hit on at all times so they're performing 100%. First thing is going to be meal choice. What foods do you eat? What's the macronutrient breakdown of all of these? So first thing I'll definitely say is don't pick foods that you're not accustomed to. So every, you know, let's say for the past month, you've been having rice, you've been having chicken, you've been having steak. Now is not the time to switch up the source of food. So now's not the time that you decide, hey, I'm gonna have a giant bowl of pasta. You don't know how your body's gonna react. You haven't had it in a while. You wanna stick to foods that you're most comfortable with. So stick with the foods that you've been eating. And if you want, you can add a little bit extra. So if you normally have 2 cups of rice, maybe have 2.5 cups of rice just to give those extra carbohydrates for that long game that you have the next day. So ultimately, keep them about the same foods that you're used to. Besides that, guys, when you wake up in the morning, you're gonna be hungry, you're gonna be excited. You wanna make sure you have what's called multiple transporter carbohydrates. So this is gonna go into my timing of food. So when you wake up, multiple transporter carbohydrates, what is that? So that's combining a starch with a fruit. See, when you eat a starch, your body will take those carbohydrates, convert it into glycogen. All glycogen is, guys, is taking carbs and putting it in the muscle. So if I have, you know, bread, it might store those carbohydrates in my bicep. And when I use the bicep, it's gonna break down that glycogen and those stored carbohydrates right there. So there's different rates at which your body converts these carbs into stored carbohydrates or glycogen. So one way it does it is through starch. It has one rate of breakdown. The other thing is through fruit. So if you get all of your carbohydrates through starch, think of it as just one lane. Okay, you're driving, there's just one lane. Now if you're eating the starch and now you have a fruit as well, now you're opening up a second lane. So these carbohydrates can turn into glycogen at a faster rate. So especially if you wake up early, you have a meal and you're about to go play your game, this is something you want to incorporate. So another thing, how many meals should you guys have? So depending on when your game is how many meals you should have. I usually like to say a meal for every 3 hours or so. So if you have, you know, your game at 9 a.m., you wake up at 6, get a meal in, and then maybe get some intra-workout carbohydrates during that game, like a Gatorade. If it's later in the day, maybe, 5 p.m., maybe, and you wake up at 6, maybe you want to have a meal at 6, at 9, at 12, then a small meal at around 2. And then, like I said, sip on a Gatorade, something like that. Make sure you're getting carbohydrates, a little bit of protein, a little bit of fat. So, big thing for this, guys, hydration and electrolytes. This is something people overlook all the time. Chances are you might be outside, it might be hot, it might be inside, and you can't control the temperature. Make sure that you have electrolytes at all times. So you could be drinking Gatorade in the morning, maybe have some salt in your meal. This will help retain some of the water, and especially when you're going out and you're performing at a high pace, you're gonna be sweating, you're gonna be getting rid of all these electrolytes, all this sodium, which is crucial for muscle contraction. So you want to make sure that you absolutely have all these things, guys. So pick meals, pick foods that you're comfortable with. Right, make sure you have a couple meals about every 2 to 3 hours before your game. Have multiple transporter carbohydrates, so try to combine a starch with a fruit. You can do this before one of your sessions, see how you feel. And having adequate water and electrolytes before, you know, your training sessions always, but especially for those game day guys. So if you want to know more about this, you can check out Performance Nutrition Guys in the link below. All of this is in there with greater detail. Tell me what you guys think, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.